the young people of today are gonna be, they're gonna be in situations when they're older where they're purchasing land, hopefully in, you know, in this area, but anywhere in the province, in the country. And to understand the importance of legal boundaries and what you obtain.
Land surveyors might have interactions with different people in a municipal setting. One of the more common interactions is probably through the subdivision application process or the process of finalizing the subdivision. So if a member of the public has gone through the process of subdividing, having a land survey completed is one of the final steps, and then a member of the municipality would be reviewing that plan and may call and have questions for that particular land surveyor. But a land surveyor is also a really good resource for a member of staff or council who just has a general question about tenure or property ownership, property boundaries, municipal boundaries. There's lots of different areas where a land surveyor can be a really good resource to somebody working in a municipality.
Well, they may want to know where their house is located, or if it's located on their property, they may want to know where the corners of the property are for building a fence or maybe adding an addition onto their house. They may want a topographical survey that gives them contours so that they can have a house designed to fit the contours of the property. There may be some sort of an easement or a right-of-way that needs to be surveyed as well for a driveway, water line, that sort of thing.
What BC Land Surveyors are ultimately responsible for is the cadastral fabric, the puzzle pieces that make up the province, the parcels of the province.
That's what cadastral means.
That's what cadastral means. It's the individual parcels and how they all fit together on a sort of macro level, the grand scheme.
The youth that have yet to experience anything to do with land surveying, if they realize that the land they live on, and not just the one parcel they live on, but the community that they live in and the town they live in was based on surveys of, you know, original Crown land, and it started probably as a forest and it slowly became, you know, cut down and subdivided into this parcel that they live on, and that all started with a survey that was much bigger than where they live, and it's, you know, has to do with the original, you know, the original ground that was there hundreds and thousands of years ago to where it is today.
For building permits and that kind of stuff, you typically will need a land surveyor to create a plan. And the reason for that is that the boundary issues go back a long ways, and you never know, you know, through the years how things have changed on the property itself. It's critical to that sort of foundation, that solid base. But at the same time, you know, we're not saving lives. It's not. I wouldn't call it critical. I would call it important.